filmmaker is supposed to be a fantastic reader. What that means is that you cannot just create from nothing. Like they say, you must know the rules before you break the rules. So today I'll be sharing with you some of the books that I feel as a filmmaker you should be able to read and learn from these writers' experiences. So I will say these are my go-to film books that you should read as a filmmaker. Okay, so let's jump right into it. But before we do that, please make sure that you subscribe. If you have not subscribed, please make sure you subscribe and hit the notification button so that you know when I drop the next video, because I do that every other week. So come with me, let's explore. All right, the very first one is Hillman Curtis. The title is On Creating Short Films for the Web. Now, one good thing I like about the book is that it actually teaches independent filmmakers how to explore the new oil world, which is the internet. And so it's specific about creating content for the web. And if you are interested and you're an independent filmmaker who wants to be making films for the internet, be it on YouTube or any other form of video on demand or free to air, as long as it's an internet and it's short films you want to focus on or short web series, please make sure you read Hillman Curtis On Creating Short Films for the Web and thank me later. Okay, my very second book I would recommend that you read if you're a filmmaker inspiring to improve on your work is Walter Murch, In the Blink of an Eye. That's the title, In the Blink of an Eye. Okay, if you know the films like Apocalypse, you know the film like The Godfather, you know, the brain behind the editing is Walter Murch, and he's the one that wrote the book In the Blink of an Eye. Like, there are so many revelations, there are so many things, there are so many details that you could find in the book In the Blink of an Eye. So if you have not read the book, or if you have not, some of these books I'm mentioning actually are on the internet and you can actually download it as an ebook and read, and I'm sure you are going to enjoy it. So my second book that I will recommend for you that you should read is In the Blink of an Eye by Walter Murch. Moving on, ever seen the movie like Sin City? Well, the writer-director Robert Rodriguez has a book he wrote called Rebel of the Crew. Now, the title also, it looks like what you may call an irony, Rebel of the Crew. And it's written by Robert Rodriguez. And if you know about independent filmmaking in US and those people that actually revolutionized the idea of independent filmmaking, this writer director is one of them. So he speaks to you from the point of view of an independent director and independent writer. And his films like Machete is also one of the, you know, best ever written scripts out of Hollywood as an independent producer and independent director. So if you want to learn a lot about tricks on how to become, you know, everything and almost everything in filmmaking, you know, we independent filmmakers, or most independent filmmakers, depend so much on them doing a lot of things. So if you want to learn how to rebel without a crew, then go read the book Rebel Without a Crew, written by Robert Rodriguez. You're going to enjoy it, I promise you that. You can download that online as we speak right now and you enjoy it. My next book that I want to recommend for you is Kristen Vachon's Shooting to Kill. Now, Kristen Vachon is one of the most sought-after producers in Hollywood, and she had to put this book together to tell you the nitty-gritties when it comes to filmmaking. So if you want to learn the tits and tats, all the basic things that you need to put together to come out with a fantastic movie, then you have to read the book Shooting to Kill. Remember, my essence of trying to mention some of these books is that some of them I've read, some of them I've ordered, some of them I'm looking forward to also read, some of them I'm looking forward to reread. It's to help you understand that there are some techniques that you can actually apply. And sometimes these techniques are quite easy, but because we feel we need to have a lot of money to make great films, the only reason why we feel that way is because we have not read some of these books, because these people started from nothing and then they got to where they are right now. So if you want to know the nitty-gritty, how to cut corners and still come out best without necessarily spending all those big money and all those big budgets, you should read Kristen's Shooting to Kill. It's a book, it's online, you can download it and you can read it. And that book is specific when it comes to the details, the step-by-step things you need to put in place from pre-production to post-production processes, and you'll be glad you read it. And the final book I will be recommending for you to read as a filmmaker is Robert Ebert's Your Movie Sucks. Now, have you ever seen a movie review that when you finish reading, you'll be like, who wrote this? Was that person actually angry? Does the person know the producer or the director? Why is this person so mad at this film? Why does this person give you so much low review? Well, Robert Ebert is somebody that if he doesn't like a movie, he doesn't like a movie. So his book is more like a collection of all the movies that he has reviewed. Sometimes they're even big budget movies and he can trash it. He tells you reasons why they are bad and terrible movies. As long as we depend on audience to determine for us who is a good artist, who made a good film or who doesn't make a good film, how movies are successful in the cinema or not, how people appreciate your film or not, as long as all of that are in the hands of the audience, I still want to say and I still want to recommend to you, read Robert Ebert's Your Movie Sucks. It's a review of most of the top Nollywood movies and some other movies that you don't even get to know about. But when you review them, he's not just reviewing them for review's sake. He gives you in-depth meaning. He gives you reasons why that movie is bad. So, and one good thing about reading reviews or watching bad movies is that it will teach you how not to make a film. So there you have it. Some of the books you must read if you truly want to be a fantastic filmmaker, independent filmmaker. And most of the books I recommend to you are films that will help you, most independent filmmakers, to move from where they are right now to where they're supposed to be. So please, if you like this content, please give me a thumbs up, make some comment on the comment section below, and make sure that you subscribe if you have not done that, because I will provide you more content as they go. Please, if you like the video, please let me know, and if you don't, tell me why you don't like it. I'm like I always say, make a suggestion for me. What content would you like me to do next? What video would you like me to do? What would you like me to talk about next? Please, when you do that, put it on the comment section below. Please, and you can also hook me up on Instagram @IamUcheAgbo. Let's talk more. Let's talk film. Let's talk creativity and all whatnot. And then before I close, finally, I have a book myself. It's called Monetize Your Talent. And make sure you read that book. Monetize Your Talent is going to teach you how you're going to put together all I've been teaching, how you can use your talent to generate funds, how you can use whatever gift you have in the creative industry to make a film. So I'm going to put the link on how to download it. Easy thing, it's easy to download, it's easy to access. I'll put the link on the comment section below. Please make sure you download Monetize Your Talent. It's a book I wrote, how you can turn your talent into money. Make sure you download and make sure you read. Till we meet again next time, thank you for watching and remain blessed. Bye-bye.